And I know you want game stuff, but this will be really quick. So, as we discussed, I feel that Austin is at the if you missed the last video, or you just want to jump in to see what the solution is, the good part. The thing is that I feel COVID is ending, things are getting back to normal, and we're still not even organized, even though we've had so much time to get our stuff together. So, and I'm wondering why that is. And, like I mentioned before, there's rivalries, but rivalries are good. Some TOs, I laugh at them. Some of them hate me. Some of them think certain things of me, or, I have like, oh man, they stole my idea. But it's like, I never really, it's never hate, like, that's how it works, right? Like, even in the fighting games, like, you take my tech, you try to do it better. I'm gonna take whatever you did, and I'm just gonna try to do that better. And that's what I think needs to happen for our scene. And it's not happening. I mentioned things that I'm doing, but one thing that I didn't want to distract from is that there are other TOs out here. And I'm not someone that's like, oh yeah, the TOs that came after me are all TOs I influenced. That's not my point, because I don't think that's the case either. What I wanted to discuss, or what I was trying to bring up, my point is that I'm aware of all these TOs. And what was disturbing to me was how none of these TOs were working together and or trying to. And I don't know what that reason is. I don't know for some of them. I do know that sometimes it's as simple as, oh, they play Smash, we don't mess with them. Or I know it's as simple as, oh, we're NRS, and we don't like to play, we don't like to hang out with the Street Fighter guys because we're NRS. So I just never understood that. It just doesn't make sense. I mean, I get if you want to have your own little group, but if we're trying to do things bigger, we should be combining. So that's what I was, that's what I'm driving at. But how can I do that, right? How can I just sit there and be like, hey guys, let's work together, and then just it happen, right? Meanwhile, I just go and throw amazing events for my scene and my game, and I try to have their game as a side game, or I try to bring in their TO and be like, hey man, come work with me and we'll do this thing. And Feel Good is the one who created this idea, so shouts out to him, fellow TO, Jacob Feel Good. So I'm gonna be working with him closely on this idea. But I mentioned it a little bit on my last Dread stream. The situation is that I know I have the respect of my players. That's why they come to my events. And I might not be the perfect TO to them. I get critiqued all the time, even by some of the out of city guys. Shouts out to Joe Crush for telling me that he hates my seating. But I realize that they are willing to deal with my stuff or whatever I do because I've earned their respect through my actions or whatever. And the one thing I've never done is I don't think I've taken the time to earn the other TO's respect. So I think what just happens is the rivalry just keeps going. They just see me and they're like, I'm gonna try to outdo that. I see them, I'm gonna try to outdo that. We never are like, hey, let's both work together and outdo our last events together. And then other times I try that, but it's just so poorly coordinated that it's blown up and then people get the wrong idea. But now I think we're at a point to where coordination should not be that hard. I understand everyone's schedules aren't perfect, but even if they're not, at least get them together. So the idea is that I'm gonna hold an event. Me and Feel Good are gonna get an event, for TOs. So I'm gonna reach out to all the TOs I know, and we're gonna have an event. And not like an event where we're gonna just press buttons against each other. I want it to be an event where we, like, I don't know. As an example, I mentioned on the thing, like, Topgolf. I'm not too much for golf, but, like, something like that where we're just hanging out. Sure, I guess we could have some games in the back, but, like, mainly just, like, get some food, grab some drinks, just chat and, like, talk. give them that chance for people to like bridge these connections and you know, get that respect and that communication going, and just let people see eye to eye better. Because that's why I think certain things just don't work out. Like, because, and that even goes for the new TOs that local host, like, they're just so detached. They're just like, hey, we just came in, we talked to this guy, we know what we're going to do, we're going to just try for it. And it's like, in order for them to succeed, they need the TOs and, you know, players who've earned the respect of their community to invest in them, because that's what the other masses also invest in. Do they? It's not that we're sheep, it's that we go where we know we all want to go because we trust the situation. And there can't be any trust or respect if we're all strangers to each other. So I've tried just having people hang out in a Discord, and that won't work because a lot of people just sit there quietly. So that's not really driving any engagement or interaction. So I do want to just have a get together where I can, you know, sit down and like talk with people. Now, after that event, once everyone knows everybody, at least for that moment in time, because, you know, people get old to age out. Once everyone knows everybody, if I see the same stuff, if I see people from the other three major cities know about a major that's in our city and no one knows about it except the out-of-towners, and they come in and steal my medals, or if I see someone try to have an amazing event with a huge opportunity for pop bonuses and it doesn't happen because no one knows it's happening and they don't reach out to anyone in the communities, if I see an event that has games that no one's playing and they're a part of your lineup or a tournament, and games that people are playing are being removed, if I see more than 50% of the volunteers for an event come from outside of the city when we have plenty of people who are able-bodied and willing to work in this city, if that keeps happening, then I will stop doing whatever it is I'm doing. And that's not saying I'm quitting. I just mean, like, I'm going to play. I'll focus on playing because I have a huge hunger to play right now. And, you know, that's kind of my focus as it is. So I'm going to do this thing, which isn't playing, right? Which isn't TOing, but I'm going to meet my current commitments that I have. So I've got Austinite fights. I've got an event, some whispers out there that I'm planning with Joey from the Smash Ultimate scene. So I got another event that we're working on there. And then I have a, the TO get together. And, yeah. After those three things, I probably won't be involved as much with a lot of things, meaning like, and what I mean by that is, yeah, I'll still run the Thirsty Low when I have the opportunity to, but I'm not gonna sit here and go out of my way to help people meet people, help drive engagement on post. I'm not gonna do marketing. I'm not gonna sit here and waste time trying to sell my brand or anything. I'm just gonna focus on getting good at the game, and hopefully through that, I'll draw attention. Because that is really what should be talking. Well, why doesn't that go from the first place? Well, the reason I was doing events and trying to have us grow in that way was we have strong players. So my goal was just to get us a platform for those strong players we have to stand on. So then other people could see them. And then, you know, they come in. But that just, it's not happening. Like, yeah, people do know of our top player, but again, because things are so scattered, we're not creating good opportunities for our top player in this city. Failing to do that is how you wind up with the situation that we see in California and in New York. Like, Not saying it'll be so drastic as he goes to California and New York, but what if he just decides, hey, I'm moving to Houston. Now he's a top player in Houston or Dallas or San Antonio. Now it's like, oh, yeah, you go to this place where they have these dope locals. And I've seen certain similar things happen where people in this city are just getting more done by working with people out of city. I'm not going to name names, but you know who you are. And I don't hate you for it. It just makes sense. You didn't do any crimes. I'm sad that we couldn't be the one to provide that platform. So instead of being sad about it, I'll just work on what I want to do as far as gaming, because I love gaming. If you don't know that. And with that all said, that is part 3. So, yeah, that's the answer, guys. I'm going to, that is the answer. I am going to begin Metroid Dread after this, but I will, I'll still run the reset, but I won't, I'm not going to care too much about other things I was planning to do, because there's no value in those things. And there's a lot of ideas I had. You know, people talk about merch, people talk about podcasts, people talk about all sorts of stuff, but it's not worth it if we can't even fix the smaller issues first. So that's what I'm going to work on. And that is the end of the TO Talk, part 3. So part 2 is going to take some time to upload. This one's there. It's a brief recap. That's all I got for you guys. I will end it on that. I'm back for Dread. Blackout.